G'day guys, Rod from Origin Campers here. Got the long range set up here. We can't take it away at the moment. Closed everything down for us, but we can still do videos and show you what we've achieved with this camper trailer. It really has come up very well. We're very excited about it. To show you a quick look inside, we've got our shelves here that we've got USB 12 volt there. Up the back in the bed area, we've got USB, plenty of storage place. Also, you could put a small child up there if they want to sleep inside with you. Bed's 1950 long by 1500 wide, good size bed. We've got food storage here, and of course, the shelf slides in, like in one of our previous videos, that stops everything coming back out when you're traveling. Got our tea towel holders up there on both sides. Like I said, we've got a spot here too for our laptop to sit if you need to do some work or look at some videos. The back door here, back door is fully insulated. We've gone for a two-tone look on the back door. Also, the ceiling in here is 50 mil insulated as well. So when it comes to insulation, it's quite good and very quiet. Got our side table here. That just gives you a little look at how much room's on that. It's pretty good little spot actually. It's quite generous. Our heavy duty guards that you can stand on to get up to your roof rack. Now it is a 3 mil guard, so it's very strong. Over here we have our pull out kitchen. Now, excuse me. Now, our pull-out kitchen is a prototype one. This is kind of the way we're setting it up. So we've got a spot for our plates and cups all downstairs. We've got our knives and forks drawer there. Somewhere to sit your gas burner when you're traveling. Take that out and put it on a table somewhere and cook up on it. We've got our fridge. Now that slides in and out. That should take about a 50 litre fridge. That's a 40. The box it's sitting in is our own design. Couldn't find anything we liked, so we decided to come up and make something that suits the look of our trailer rather than put some box on there that doesn't really look good. Heading around here into a bit of storage here. Now behind that toilet there is the battery spot. That's where the battery sits in there. We've got a 150 amp AGM in there at the moment. Come stand with a 120 amp, put a larger one in for our use. Now that plug down the bottom, that's where we bring the lead up, 240 leads. You can hear our charger humming away quite nicely in there, charging up that battery. Fridge has been on for about 2 days in there sitting by itself, and of course you've got to keep the power up to them, otherwise they go too far down. Let's have a quick look in this box. Now that's the other side of the box there, so you've got a bit of storage on this side as well. Roughly about 350 mil to the back of the fridge there, so you've got a fair bit of space there, and it's about 570 roughly high, so still got a fair bit of height there. And up on our box up here, we've got our wood storage basket. Now this surface here is rubber checker plate. Managed to find some that pretty well suits the checker plate on the front of the trailer. Almost identical, so it looks really cool. And of course that's aluminium underneath, that's all powder coated. We've got our big heavy duty A-frame set up with the strap underneath it, front tire mounted, McHitch, handbrake set up, the usual sort of things on that bit. And we've got our roof rack set up there, I'll show that in a minute. Again, heavy duty side guards, twin water tanks, so it's 120 litres. Got our drop down stabiliser legs Some people don't put them on these camp trails, but I do. I like them. Keeps them from wobbling around at night time when you're sleeping in there. Back into the bed area. So, again, a good size, good height to the ceiling, so you don't feel stuffy in there. And there is a three-speed ceiling fan. Sorry, this is a single-speed one in this one. You can have a three-speed. We do put three speeds in the other one. There you go. Up on top, got our roof rack set up there. We put all the roof racks at the back on this one until we get an awning on it, and we'll move one forward and set it all up. Our water tank set up there. As I said before, you connect the hose up to it, crack the valve underneath for the air release, and you pop the water in through the hose. It fills up very quickly. It's a good little unit. And back to our kitchen. Haven't had a chance to use it yet, so it's kind of sitting here waiting to go out. But certainly looking forward to it. Once this gets a full awning on it, it's going to be a weapon of a trailer. You know, it's lightweight. It goes really well. We've towed it a bit, but not enough to take it out for a big run. Like I said, we only towed it to get it registered and approved and bring it back here. It's about 880 kilos dry weight. So pretty lightweight trailer. All right, guys, that's it from me from Origin Campers. Hope you like the look of the trailer. Thanks, guys.